Hi everyone, my name is Victoria and I'm a park interpreter for Santa Clara County Parks. Like many of you, due to COVID-19, I've been sheltering in place. And because of that, I've been forced to rediscover the beauty and the mystery of nature in my local parks, in my walks around the neighborhood, and even in my own backyard. Today, we are going to be conducting a nature investigation. What exactly are we going to be investigating? These strange things that I found on one of my most recent walks. When you look a little closer, they're actually really, really fascinating. So let's do that together. So do you think that you've seen these spiky, they're kind of like ping pong ball, or they can even be kind of golf ball sized things before? Let's look a little closer. What do you think? Have you seen them before on a tree close to your house or in your local county park? We're gonna look even closer, but before we do that, I wanna tell you a little bit about the trees where you can find them.
There are two species that you're likely to come across in the Bay Area. There's the California sycamore and the London plane tree. California sycamores are a native riparian tree, meaning that they're commonly found along creeks. They can grow to be quite massive, and their trunks usually lean pretty dramatically. More common in urban settings is the London plane tree. The London plane tree isn't native. It's actually a hybrid between the American sycamore and the Oriental plane tree. This tree is commonly planted along sidewalks because of its ability to grow with cramped root conditions. Both the California sycamore and the London plane tree produce lots of shade with their large lobed leaves. Both trees also have beautiful bark that peels away in irregular patches, almost creating what looks like a camouflage pattern. Small flowers appear in clusters in the early spring, gradually ripening into fruit balls that turn brown in the fall. Right now, these trees are just starting to leaf out, which means that the spiky balls from last fall can still be seen hanging off the tree's bare branches, almost like decorative ornaments.
Believe it or not, but these spiky balls are actually made up of hundreds of seeds. Hundreds. Pretty crazy. But in order for one of these seeds to grow into a mighty tree, it needs a handful of things, right? It needs sunlight, it needs water, nutrients, and it needs space. It needs space to get all of those resources. Now, trees don't have legs, so they need to figure out ways to move that are kind of creative and utilize the power of other things that you find in nature. Any ideas what that might be by looking at these?
In order for the seeds to travel away from the parent tree to an area suitable for growth, the tree uses the wind to do the job of dispersal. Every seed has a few feathery hairs that allow it to catch the wind, almost like mini parachutes. These seeds can be eaten by birds like finches, chickadees, and juncos, or other animals like squirrels.
So the next time that you're out on your walk, keep an eye out for these things. They could be on the ground, they could still be hanging from trees. And consider yourself lucky, because if you get to look at one a lot closer up, and maybe even break it apart, like this, doesn't take much. It's pretty satisfying. And maybe one day one of these seeds will be a mighty tree. Thanks for joining today's nature investigation. Be sure to tune in again to see what other things we can find close to home.